And Eloise here for Pretty Pink Posh, and today I have another three cards, one stamp set video for you all. So I'm going to be using the Sea Friends stamp set today, and I just really love this one since it had a lot of critters in it, had a lot of sentiments in it, and that's what I really love when I make these videos. I'm also using a bunch of Pretty Pink Posh dies to help me create the scene today. So I'm going to be using the Stitched One dies, the Smile Shaker dies, the Stitched Diamonds dies, and also the Scalloped Diamond tag dies, and then I'm also pulling in the cloud dies just from the coordinating stamp set, or the coordinating die set of the stamp set Fly Kite, and that's just because I wanted to create those, use those clouds to create some waves today. I'm also already pre-colored and cut out all of my images from the Sea Friends stamp set. Also, I just colored these in with Copic markers just off camera to make the entire process go a little bit faster. So to begin my first card today, I'm going to start off sort of with, I wouldn't really call it partial die cutting, but I'm sort of altering the die cut a little bit. So I'm just starting off with the Scalloped Diamond Tags dies, and I'm just cutting the largest tag out of some Nina Solar White cardstock, and I'm just cutting this out normally, and then I'm going to alter it. So I'm just going ahead, and when I cut the tag out, I just cut it out normally so I had the little top of the tag on it, but I sort of wanted to cut that off, so I just flipped the die around 180 degrees so the top of the tag piece would now be on the bottom of the die cut tag piece, and I'm going to run this through again. So I just pushed the die into place to make sure that all of those little scallops on the sides lined up nicely, and they did. And then I'm just going to run just the end with the additional sort of cutout piece on it through my Big Shot machine. So I just cut that out. So you can see here, I'm lining up the plates to just cut the top of that die, and then I'm going to have a perfectly sort of diamond piece, I suppose, without that little additional tag piece on the top. So I really love altering my die cuts this way, and it works really well with these tag dies because you can either have them as a tag or have them as a layer like that, because they don't have the hole cut into them, so they're really easy to alter. Then I just took the Stitched Diamonds die set, and I'm just going to lay the middle size in that set into the center of this tag piece, and then I just wanted to create sort of a frame, so I ran that through my Big Shot machine, and you can see there that it created a nice frame to frame my scene. So then I'm using the Stitched Borders one set, and I just die cut the sort of scalloped piece that I made into a wave by using the negative piece, and I'm going to use that as a layer behind my frame here. So now I'm going to go ahead and ink blend three colors of Distress Oxide ink onto this wave piece. So I wanted it to go sort of like from a minty to a blue to a dark blue, and so that's why I decided to use the Distress Oxide inks, and also because these blend on really smoothly, and you don't get any harsh lines or anything like that, and so I really love the seamless look you get with them. So I'm first starting off with Cracked Pistachio, and then I'm moving on to Broken China, and I'm just blending that into the middle of this piece, sort of making sure I overlap the mint, the Cracked Pistachio color, to get a really nice blend. And then I'm going in with the Faded Jeans, and then blending that in, and then going back through the colors in reverse to blend those all together, and I really love the smooth finish that you get from the Distress Oxide inks. It looks really gorgeous. So then I just used my little water spritzer bottle and took the nozzle out and just flicked on a little bit of water just to give sort of a water splotch effect, and I think that works really well for bubbles in the ocean, so that's why I did that. Then I've just skipped ahead, and I've taken a piece of yellow watercolor cardstock from the Watercolor Wishes paper pad from Lawn Fawn, so I've just cut that down to size to fit my card base. Then I just added a blue piece of cardstock and also the ink blended piece behind my little frame image here, and then just adhered that down onto the card. Now I'm just taking some images that I've already previously colored that I showed earlier, and I've just placed them into my scene. So I used the seahorse and the octopus images, then I've also used some coral and seaweed images as well, and I'm just going to adhere these all down to the background of my card using liquid adhesive for the seaweed and coral, and foam adhesive to adhere down the seahorse and the jellyfish, or the octopus, I should say. Then I just also skipped ahead and used some black cardstock and used the Hello Friend sentiment from the same Sea Friend stamp set and white heat embossed that onto the black cardstock, cut it into a skinny strip, and adhered it onto my card with foam adhesive as well. So that finishes up card number one. You can see a couple of close-up pictures here of the card. And then I'm going to move on to card number two. So for my second card, I'm going to be first creating a distress ink embossed background. So, I'm going to first coat this piece of watercolor cardstock with my powder tool just to eliminate any stray embossing powder sticking to where I don't want them. And then I'm going to use the Sea Friend stamp set once again to stamp some images in Versamark ink on my background. So, I'm sort of just making, I guess, my own pattern paper. So, I'm using the largest images first from the stamp set to fill in a lot of the gaps. And then I'm using the medium-sized images to fill in after that. And then the smallest images last to fill in any random white spaces. So I've just gone ahead and stamped out all of my images. Then I clear heat embossed those with some clear embossing powder and a heat tool. And now I'm getting ready to ink blend over the top. So I'm using pumice stone distress ink here, and I really wish that I had a lighter grey. This one was a bit too dark. I tried to go in really light-handed, but it wasn't really working the way I wanted it to. So I just decided to go really heavy in the center and then sort of blend out that grey into white at the sides, since I figure a lot of the center's going to be covered up anyway. And so then I sort of achieved the light grey look anyways. So once I finished sort of ink blending over this background, I'm just going really light on the sides, just get a really nice seamless blend. And then I'm just going to flick on a little bit of water droplets just to add a little bit of extra to the background. And then I'm going to pick that up with a microfiber cloth and then heat set this entire background with my heat tool so I can get on to assembling the sequin shaker portion. So for the sequin shaker portion, my head was in the way for most of the filming of it, but basically, I just die cut the smile shaker frame die out of some Nina Solar White cardstock and added some adhesive onto the back and adhered it down to an acetate piece. Then I added a double layer of foam tape all around the outside of this smile shaker frame here, and then I just added in my sequins. So I just used some mermaid mix that are new for July. I also used some cornflower and some aquamarine sequins as well, just to add a little bit more in there, since I didn't want to use up too much of that mermaid mix. I'm gonna have to buy so many more packets of that. I love it so much. And then I just added a blue piece of cardstock on the bottom of this piece for the shaker portion, and that's just again from the Watercolor Wishes paper pad from Lawn Fawn once again. So once all of those were adhered, I did adhere it flat down to the card as well. And then I just picked out a few images that I felt fitted in well with the design and adhered those down onto my card as well. So I just used a little bit of foam tape to help prop up the edges of the side there where that, like, the dolphin's gonna overlap, just so it didn't sag or anything. And then I just used like flat adhesive or liquid adhesive to adhere down the rest of my images. So basically that finishes up my second card. I did a really fun sequin shaker, which I really love. Having that little embossed resist background with the sequin shaker in the middle makes for a really fun card. So now that I've finished up the second card, I'm going to move on to the third card. So for my third card, I'm again pulling out the Stitched Porter's One Die. So I'm using the scalloped piece again, and also like the curved edge of this one as well. This is when I'm also going to be pulling in the Quinine dies from the Flykite stamp set as well. I'm just using the one little cloud die to create some sort of waves into my cards. So to begin this card, I'm going to use one piece of watercolor cardstock to cut out both of my layers that I need for my card. So I'm first going in with this scalloped border here, but again, I'm using it as a wave and just using the negative piece. I'm also then using the bottom of this piece of cardstock to cut out the little sandbank, or the curved die that I'm going to create this piece into a sandbank. So I really love using one piece of cardstock for both layers. I could only do this though because the whole piece isn't going to cover the entire background of the card, and there's going to be a lot of white space. So now that both of my pieces have been cut, I'm going to go ahead and ink these pieces with distress ink. So I'm first using mustard seed, and this is just a lighter of the two yellows that I'm picking out today. So I'm just going really light-handed on my ink blending here. I can sort of go darker on the top because I'm going to come in with the fossilized amber and darken that top piece up anyway, but I do really want to keep the bottom piece really super light so it looks like a really fun ombre gradient look. So then this went in with fossilized amber, and now I'm just going in with that mustard seed ink blender once again and sort of going over the entire top of that piece to make it blend all together well. Now I'm going in with some blues for my sea or ocean portion of this piece. So I'm just using tumbled glass on the very top, and you can see here that on the left of the sandbank piece and on the top of this ocean piece, the washi tape sort of removed the top layer of the cardstock and sort of removed some of that paper. But that's okay because I'm going to eventually cover the sandbank piece with images, so you're not going to see that. And then I'm also going to cut down this ocean piece further with another run through of that scalloped die and just remove that top piece since I didn't have any images I could cover that up with without the card looking strange. So now that I have finished ink blending that background piece, I'm going to adhere both of my pieces together, and then I'm getting ready to partially die cut. So I'm taking this cloud die and I'm just wanting to run through the bottom of this cloud die sort of to create an opening in my card and to have sort of that wave-like effect. And I really thought that these clouds would be super fun to do that with. So basically I just lined up the top plate onto the bottom of my image, so the pressure was only being applied to the bottom of the cloud and not to the top, so it created a little opening so you could tuck a little image into there instead of cutting the entire cloud piece out. So now that I've cut that out three times out of my background piece, and then once all of those have been die cut, I'm going to start placing in my images. So I'm just using the whale and the octopus and also the seahorse image along with a few other little accent images as well. And I'm just going to have the three main images peeking out through those little die cut areas that I wanted. And this is what I really wanted to do. I love having little peekaboo elements on my cards like this, where it's sort of peeking out through something rather than just adhered on top. So I'm really glad that these cloud dies work for the perfect waves as well. I mean, you could even do an entire wave border from these dies as well. I think that would be really fun to do instead of it being so perfect like that scalloped border is. I really liked that for the top of the card, but I wanted something a bit more whimsical in the main focus in the center of the card. So I've just gone ahead and placed all of my images down and then adhered them using some foam adhesive and also some liquid adhesive or some flat adhesive. And then I'm just going to go ahead and use the thanks friend sentiment and white heat emboss that onto some black cardstock and just cut that down into a little strip as well and adhere that onto my panel of my card. Now I'm adding some foam adhesive onto the back of this panel piece and adhering it onto my card base. I'm also adhering this quite wonky because when I ran through the panel again with the scalloped die piece, I cut it crooked, so it wasn't completely straight. So when I adhered it down straight onto the card, it looked really funny, so I decided to just adhere it at an angle and so it looked like it was all meant to be. So this finishes up the three cards that I made with the Sea Friends stamp set. I really love creating three cards with one stamp set. It really pushes me to be super creative and create really three different looking cards. So you can see a close up here of all three of the cards I made today using Pretty Pink Posh dies. If you're not subscribed to the Pretty Pink Posh channel already, please hit subscribe below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you all next time.